Success! Welcome to the Aftershock Corner, Season 3, Episode 9. Owen is not here, so I've taken over duties as host.
With me. He's on top rope.
Yeah. Fuck him.
Right now, at 11 o'clock for a 7 o'clock show.
You can't blame other people for brainwashing Owen. And you know who I'm talking about, and you know who you are.
I don't know who you are.
I don't know who he is either.
I am your host, King Tutton. I am King Tut with my podium, which is feeling a lot better after our last show where someone or nothing lost it.
I don't know who that is.
It's virginity was taken.
Yep.
As you can see, there's a giant hole in the back of it.
Yes.
So it must be very loose because there's a giant hole in the back of it.
It was taken by former South Power Regional Wrestling interviewer, Clint Buck.
Yeah.
So
I have
my notes. We have everything all set. So with me, as always, is
your champion of the universe, universal champion. I can't say that. Your champion of the universe, champion of space and time, and the space-time continuum. Where we're going, there is no roads. Your champion, Clint Buster.
Get on with it!
Lance Catamaran himself, Mr. Doug.
And
I am, as always, the dragon slaying, monster slaying, and on occasion. Oh, I forget the word.
Come up with it.
What's the word? I am the Mega Mark, Steve Chapman.
I used to slay smarts, by the way.
You were just waiting for me, like, what is it, why are you standing over here?
Yeah.
It took you 5 minutes to say your opener.
All right, then thank you.
Mine was important because you know why? Because I'm the television champion. I didn't have to look at it this time, guys.
And
I think I'm growing
right
up.
Next week, but he'll get it wrong the week after because the week after there will be a new champion. Either champion.
Yeah, Bamble Claw's gonna be the new champion.
No, Al.
Screw it. Mr. Sako's gonna be the champion.
I'll bring in my Mr. Sako, actually.
I have Mr. Sako as well.
Wait, I would give it all
over. Yeah.
But you're right now, you're not the champion.
I have a.
I have a
Mr. Bagel.
I mean,
Mr. Bagel is broken.
I have a red plaid shirt that's autographed by Foley.
Alright, so.
You're not the champion of the universe, you can't talk.
The way this is going to work is that we're going to do our normal format of
talking English.
We're going to talk whatever the fuck
you want. Can't talk English.
Yeah.
So you can't talk English.
Okay.
Leave Steve alone, he's not talking English today.
Fine. Chris, may open. What's your opening thought?
I thought this week was okay. For both shows, could have been better, especially on the Raw side. SmackDown just kind of eh. This week, as per usual, SmackDown is usually very eh recently. I really enjoyed the AJ and Shane stuff at the beginning and the end. I love the use of the becoming tag team champions. The Lost Total Bella segment can blow me. Corbin versus Orton. Orton getting knighted with a cross really kind of was weird.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure that someone in the back was thinking Undertaker crucifying Stone Cold, but then they realized their panties and they didn't go through with it.
So let's have him, you know, use a cross instead. This is gonna be religious.
Well, I mean, then again, they could have invited Raven and Sandman to help them out.
Well, they could have brought back, you know, Bible Thumping Jake Roberts back, I guess, from 96. As you can see, our host has mysteriously disappeared. I don't know where he went. Might have to call for help. He's disappeared.
As he
struggles to find an ancient life.
Because
he's taking everything up his path to come back to Earth. And there's our gracious host.
And our screens are black.
And screens black. Who cares? It happens all the time.
It's alright. It's so boring.
It's screensaver mode.
Yeah, you see.
What is your screensaver?
We have a 20th Century Fox with a donut. What do you see?
Who's coming over your screensaver right now?
We also have a Michael Bay picture with a portion of the back saying destroying childhood memories one movie at a time.
Yep.
Batman single. Another 20th Century Fox logo. And a Batman and a Joker Harley Quinn. That's it. Alright. Where were we?
I don't even know.
We were talking
about
how you got to lose the belt.
We're going to talk about how you're a pansy ass motherfucker and you have to actually beat me for the championship. Because
okay.
I'm actually going to hand over the championship unless if I hold it until after WrestleMania. Then I'm literally going to have to give it up, but I'm only going to be a champion at name only.
Yeah, don't worry. I'm probably going to win it Saturday and then lose it back to you Sunday, so who cares?
Hey, I forgot the event Saturday, too.
Hey, let's not forget something.
It's a free for all.
It's a Lance Cameron.
I can actually win the title for a fourth time.
Fourth time?
In my illustrious career as host.
The big first surprise.
Hey, I actually have an easy, bucket this time. Don't need a shoot.
So, before we get off topic
again
any farther than we already are, I thought the opening segment to Raw was really, really fucking good. Stephanie in her usual ball chopping mode.
Wow. Wait, sorry, I got a hold of that nose. Welcome to Monday Night
Raw. You sound like Slimer if you want to
confess.
So we have Mick Foley in the ring. Comes up, huge pop as per usual. He comes out and basically reads off note cards that he has to resign as general manager of Monday Night Raw. But he rips the cue cards up and says, you know, in a passionate speech by Mick Foley, as we're accustomed to.
And then
cue cards! You give me cue cards! And rips them up.
As per usual, Stephanie McMahon came out with her hedge clippers.
Down. Oh, that's not, it's not just scissors, it's not just a knife anymore, it's fucking hand clippers.
I call that, it's a razor. You know what the old fashioned barber is where just one, just a better use.
But next week it's gonna be
a bone saw. Bone saw is ready.
So she's gonna tell me bone.
Saw?
What's saw?
And she's gonna say,
hey, freak show!
It's funny,
that would be a good thing because that would mean still GM if it wasn't going anywhere.
But it comes down to, you know, Mick needed it.
Yep.
Because he is having hip surgery.
It's like some other wrestlers that will get too big.
And then, you know, he knew it was time for himself to go. I don't think he'll be gone for long. I think he'll just after, you know, he's going to be out for probably the rest of the year. Well, closer to the rest of the year. Probably not the rest of the year. But we'll see him, I think we'll see him again in some capacity. Whether it be, you know, a manager or
murder Mr.
Bagno. Or going against the authority. Because they can't technically, oh, well, he got fired. But so he's technically fired, so he can do whatever he wants.
I have an idea of what he's going to do later on, and that is when Noelle Foley, hopefully, if she's good, debuts on the main roster, or even in NXT, he'll manage it for a bit.
No, I think what's going to happen is he's going to interfere with Triple H, Seth Rollins, and Chance.
That's why it's an unsanctioned match.
And my hope is, screw Mr. Socko, let's see the barbed wire back.
Barbie?
Yeah.
We can bring out Barbie.
I mean, it's unsanctioned. It's unsanctioned.
It's not like he even used it.
Unsanctioned. M-A-T-C-H. Unsanctioned. Means he can do whatever the fuck he wants to do.
Yep.
Hey, if you can do whatever the hell you want, then be smart. You know, Triple H don't bring out the sledgehammers, bring out the katana. Pull it up.
Alright, so what are you doing?
Yeah.
Hell, go find Pelton 9mm Glock. Bring him out. Oh, you won't. Okay.
What's on your mind for this week?
Well, there's really not much to talk about when it comes to cell phone wrestling. All I have to say is watch it. You know, it's one of those things you watch once and then done, but I actually want to talk about WWE in a way that connects to another company that they are potentially behind.
Oh, Ring of Honor.
Yeah. WWE might be buying up Ring of Honor. Apparently, their conversation of doing it has been going on since January. I think this was via the internet, too. So,
it's been happening since 2016.
It happens to me. My Boston accent comes out every now and then. I can't control it. I'm sorry. All right, so, yeah.
Shut up.
So, anyhow, it was reported that since January, there have been discussions going on of WWE buying out Sinclair, something like properties.
Sinclair Broadcasting.
Yeah, and that would include Ring of Honor. And if that were to happen, don't just stick all of them in NXT. You know, pick a few that are just going to pop up on Raw, like what Gallows and Anderson did, you know? Just because it's an indie company, it doesn't necessarily mean everyone there is an indie wrestler. Some of them are clearly like WWE level talent. Like AJ, in my opinion, has been a WWE talent since 2007. That's just my opinion.
Bobby Roode. Nakamura.
Once Roode turned heel and won the title, I felt like he was a real star, personally.
What do you mean turned heel and won the title?
And TNA.
They're talking about him like he's been doing right
now. Yeah, TNA, when he turned heel, cut his hair, turned on Storm, and won the title.
Because you know why?
I tune in every week to watch Bobby Roode.
Say it. Why is
that? You know, I didn't like...
No, so like, why is that? What's the word? Good
heel.
Ben Stewart,
please, yeah. Alright, Bobby Roode turned heel in like 2011.
That was a big thing.
He turned heel in 2011.
Glorious, damn it! That was the word I'm looking for here.
Oh, yeah, you gave his glory. He's
fucking idiot.
Stupid.
Hey, you weren't even listening.
I wasn't listening, I didn't get it.
Anyhow, WWE buys out TNA.
Not TNA.
I don't give a
buys out TNA.
I don't want them to buy out TNA.
What the hell is TNA?
I want them to buy out Impact Wrestling.
Fuck is Impact Wrestling?
I want them to buy out that company Jeff Jarrett's running.
Into the ground.
He's trying not to.
Twice, actually. Because he almost did it the first time.
Anyhow.
And
yeah,
I was.
They bought out Ring of Honor. There are a few stars that don't want to just take in
Carter
NXT. Because a few of them are older that really wouldn't have much time to do anything in NXT and that they might be out of it by the time they get to the roster, but. People I put on the main roster would be Jay Lethal.
Yes. All the way, yes, on that.
Despite knowing Chris Dodd does not like them, the Young Bucks.
The Young Bucks wouldn't be on.
They signed the Ring of Honor, though.
They have a New Japan contract.
Oh, they have a New Japan contract. See, it was my understanding that their contract was with ROH.
You got it wrong. Not the Young Bucks.
Their contract is with ROH, but they also have a. They have a contract with New Japan.
All right.
That's why they appear in New
Bucks.
Japan more than do Ring of Honor.
Adam Cole would be on.
Yeah, Adam Cole's on the radar anyways.
Even though I've already been going to NXT, but if it's the entire ROH roster, then you're gonna have to.
They're gonna have to weed out a lot of.
Are the Hardys
contract
with Ring of Honor?
No. So the thing with they're interested in right now, Dalton Castle
would be great in NXT, I think.
Leo Rush.
NXT.
He's 23 years old. He's super fucking young.
ACH.
AC. I don't think ACH is with them anymore.
No.
You
mean Steve Song took them. Really looked off for some array. Legit, listen to them side by side. I'm not joking.
Hey, what was the first time that we heard about the...
Besides, there's Cole. There's only three right now, but also, too... If you think of it, if they do buy out Ring of Honor, look at the talent that they have to pick from.
Plus,
Daniels, Kazan, they have the
addiction.
They have the addiction to pick from. The fucking Briscoes, single-handedly the best tag team on the indie scene for a decade.
You know what buying out ROH does to New Japan? It damages them. Because now they don't have a real partner to work with. and that's going to damage them trying to make an American expansion.
Well, they still got...
Hey, don't get me wrong. They still got stars, but...
But it does...
How many of them are going to make it?
Right, and like, Steve, can you bring up this point? Like, they're more equivalent to a Ring of Honor over here in New Japan.
Yeah.
Like,
New Japan is WWE to Japan, but they're Ring of Honor to America.
Yeah.
And the thing is, I said it before, you know, not to sound like a racist, like, oh, if you don't talk English, you're not good. I'm just saying, if you don't talk English, people are going to have a hard time understanding
English.
What you're saying. If you
speak English, you don't talk English.
Talk English, speak English, blab English.
Or how about this, translations?
Yes, but translations only go so far. You're going to want someone who can cut a passionate promo in, like, audible English.
Play it off.
No, a few people here and there, it's fine. Like, Kenny Omega will be able to come out and talk perfect English. I know that. Okada, I'm not
You're
sure.
Racist bastard.
What?
Okada can.
Okada can speak English.
How are we going to say Okada can speak English?
Yeah. Okada can.
But there are probably a few guys over there.
Nakamura, they can all speak English. It's just not. No, with Nakamura, it's more of a thick accent.
Yeah, Okada doesn't really have
that. I don't remember anything. I know. They said that Okada is fluent in English, but I haven't had him talk in like 7 years.
I'm just being brutally honest at this point, like just saying that you're probably gonna have to speak decent English to get yourself over. That's
it's good to differentiate yourself.
Well, they're gonna get an audience of wrestling fans,
yeah.
which will probably lead to better things. But there are still WWE sheep.
Hey, I'm not a sheep.
Bah.
A goat. You know why?
I what?
You idiot.
I'm going by that.
You're the greatest of all time.
John Wan Speed Zero. John 2 Speed Zero.
Are we talking the first person?
Yeah. Alright.
Steve Zero.
So,
Chris Scott, former Aftershock former Universal.
He hasn't lost it yet.
I'm sorry. This is the class from where I take my science fiction class. We're talking about time traffic, so I was thinking about the future.
Alright, so.
Well, the thing is, too, even if it is the future, guess what? It's now. And guess what? I'm the fucking champion. So, therefore, you actually have to predict better than me to be the champion.
Comes over to America. Does
you have to predict better than me.
Does anyone from WWE leave for them?
Predict.
Because right now it only seems like people leave New Japan for WWE.
Predictions, baby.
They might.
You got to predict.
Daniel Bryan is a name that kind of gets tossed around because he's been cleared by doctors, just not WWE doctors. Here's the thing, I'm not sure where. Obviously, I don't think he wants wrestling to ruin his marriage. And I don't know if Brie in real life would be comfortable with him wrestling. I don't know that. I don't think anyone does because we all know how real Total Divas is.
Yeah, totally scripted.
No, it's real. Sticks and sliced bread.
So this is it, huh, Fox?
What?
Sliced bread? That's really the best that we've got? 100,000 years on this earth is the best we got is sliced fucking bread. The fucking pyramids! Pat of the Canal, Great Wall of China. A lot of land, even. To me, it's better than sliced bread. You have bread, you have, like, slice the fucking thing.
Hey, I like bread. You can't eat a pyramid.
You get all of your life.
You want to know why? You know who died from trying to eat pyramids? King Tut.
Eat pyramids?
Yeah.
Did you just say eat pyramids?
Yeah, King Tut died from eating a pyramid in the inside up, because that's where he's resting. Get it? Because his nickname's King Tut.
Yeah, but pharaohs can't eat pyramids.
Pyramids eat stone.
Dumbass.
Hey, I prefer the term idiot.
Well, that's
usually
not.
Usually with the adjective stupid in front of it.
Well, that's not possible anymore because.
Alright, so.
It's defunct.
Idiot or not, I'm going to be the champion.
Well, it doesn't matter. It's not a couple of weeks.
Alright,
so I'm going to.
It's not a couple of weeks.
And
now.
Poster of Italy. Poster of the year.
Okay.
That's right back.
That's the middle finger.
That's the stupid glasses.
That's
It's a stupid sweatshirt. That's
all right. That is the logo of a team that needs to get this shit together. And they're slowly getting it together.
Smart. You are a fucking genius.
I know.
Where do they get these people, John?
I'm getting my education.
Alright, so I will def. Are you doing anything?
Education.
Yeah. Oh, well, I was wondering if you had an answer to who would be WWE for me.
Maybe some disgruntled.
So I can name one.
Daniel?
The American Dragon, Brian Danielson.
I don't think any of the fresh AJ, fresh guys like AJ and the club would leave after being in the WWE a short amount of time. But disgruntled guys like Ziggler.
Yeah. Lower totem guys.
Or the smiling doofus asshole Wayne Brady, otherwise known as Paul Cruz.
I'm definitely not on Star Wars.
The Fashion Police.
Someone can hit him a
Hall.
Someone give him a cup. I think that's why James Ellsworth is still there.
James Ellsworth?
I was going to say,
The thing is, too, with Jinder Mahal, test him!
No, I think he's going to have...
Should that be one of our signs if we're going to SmackDown? Give Jinder a cup.
Because that makes us
one
Raw.
Jinder, one cup. Thank you. Cup
one
has to be...
Oh,
cup
Jesus
to be
Christ!
Cup has to be... ready to
two girls, no cup.
Brown. Cup has to be...
That's just the thing with...
Got color code this shit.
One ginger, five cups.
Yeah.
He's gonna find one entry to put him in.
Ginger Rusev, one cup.
Oh Jesus!
The fact that you thought of two guys is really.
Prime's gets me.
Yep. My arrest. Up against.
Ah. Sorry, guys, so this interruption, Steve is a disgusting human being, and I think we all know this.
Okay, so. Alright, so now I can get to the main topic of the show.
It is commitment to this championship, so I'm not going to let us
leave. I will defer my take to when we get to that.
Hey, Brian Griffin, chill out.
So, let me do my worms thing. I'll get on the floor and do my worms thing right now.
Go ahead, do it.
I dare you. Right in front of the camera. Do it.
I don't even care, it's awesome.
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, we've officially descended into chaos. What's up, Owen?
I don't think they can see you.
You don't think they can see?
Take two.
Alright.
God damn it.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That was awful. Try it again.
That was awful.
I did it.
That was awful.
I can see you do it. Go on.
That's pretty awful.
Do it.
I'm not stupid enough to do it, that's why. Because I am the fucking champion.
That's not how we can save
the
that.
Yeah,
save
that hand.
Okay, I'm going to drop the...
I'll hold it up. I'd rather... It'll be hidden in the...
I'd rather a distinguished champion come after me.
You are...
Potentially a four-time champion, even, yeah.
World Television Champion.
Maybe.
Champion.
I'd like to see a four-time champion. Not a two-time chump.
Actually, a one-time chump.
Oh, three of them. What? That's right.
I'm taking that belt back.
In fact, he's 0-2 against him.
At least I can get my jacket off properly.
Unlike some former champions.
At least I don't write to tables.
This right here.
Unlike some former champions.
Actually, you do.
You did.
You flipped into it. Right,
that's it.
No, that's not
through a table. I flipped into a table.
That's the same thing.
There's a distinguished difference.
Look at the adjective. Play.
Take care. Right.
Oh my God.
Up on my front.
Oh!
I don't think I caught my
kick. Oh!
But anyway, I'm gonna defer my kick to when we get to that point in the show. So
what are we doing? Speaking of that, what are we doing? Predictions.
Predictions.
A week from today, right?
A week from today.
Predictions. Otherwise known as Doomsday.
Doomsday.
I gotta sit in this thing.
Yes, do it. Yes. Get your ass up there. Champions. Champions challenge.
This is
gonna
end so
poorly.
Hold on,
we have to hold this down.
Alright.
I had it perfectly the other way. You fucking moved it.
Alright, let's get this thing off. Chris. Alright, let's get this thing off.
It's stuck in the hole.
Stuck in the hole? God damn it, Paige.
Just like a few of our former teams.
Alright.
No, I'm
just kidding.
God damn it,
Paige.
You're
stuck
in the hole. I'm just kidding. Hey,
alright.
I guess
you're
stuck in whose hole? Xavier.
I'm gonna test my luck again.
Successful question. Alright, let's get things started here. Owens affirmed.
I think we already started. Sidetracked about 20 minutes.
You know what I think we should do is, because as per usually we don't want to talk about everything on Raw, we'll just go promo by promo. We'll just say yes or no, maybe so, I don't know. And that's
it.
So, we talked about the Bullet promo and the castration.
Castration.
So we'll say.
Let me get through the whole promo right here.
We'll say yes or no if we liked it.
Okay.
So WWE Raw happened on. This makes no sense. He didn't change the date of this thing. 3/13/17, which was 2 weeks ago. Which is last week. Raw happened.
Time travel was a thing in this room.
Raw happened on 3/20/17. Our commentators have been for
the same people that's been for almost a year now.
Corey Graves, Michael Cole, Byron Sexton.
Brian Sexton.
Bye, Ron.
We came to you live from the Brooklyn,
Aaron
from the Barclays Center.
And no commentators.
Spring boob.
Flower pants.
Spring boob.
Spring boob. Which the crowd started with.
Let's. We want Paige. We want Paige. Why? Because you got fucked in the pussy by Xavier Woods.
It's really, it's getting old.
Let's flip this podium around for a second. That's how big Paige's vagina is after Xavier Woods pounded her.
Various of the people.
I'm
Mexican, a white man.
It's so difficult.
He sees everything.
It's really difficult to concentrate on schoolwork with all this page crap going on. I'm trying to read the book Into the Woods. I'm on page 69 right now. I'm just trying to get through.
Joe Zane.
Yes.
Yeah. All right, let's talk about it. Shoot.
It was. I mean, it served a point.
You didn't think Sami Zayn could be the next Mick Foley, you're thinking about it.
Now that you bring up the point, yeah. Because he's losing a lot, but he's not losing in he's not losing in squash fashion.
Yeah.
He's gaining sympathy.
I hate it.
He doesn't need the sympathy card though, because he comes up to a thunderous pop.
I hate it, I love it at the same time, because it just makes that one win he gets.
Like,
so
it's
much better.
Better.
You know what I mean?
Nope.
Are you
just Brass Knucks. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18. Imagine waking us up.
No, you
gotta
keep going. Keep going.
You segment punch now.
Actually, no.
20.
21.
Nine,
you got 21, I got 22.
22 because I said 21 like that.
Okay.
Alright.
So this actually does go into an arching discussion that we've had in the chat so many crazy times. What constitutes a heel? What can a heel get away with as opposed to what can a face get away with?
Fine. Cheating. Stealing. Unless your name happens to be Eddie Guerrero.
Edwesto.
That's about it.
Edwesto.
The one exception.
Edwesto.
That's the one exception. Okay, are we all settled here? You know what a heel can get away with?
No. I'm confused.
A heel can get away with being a sibling asshole.
No, he can't be.
Why can't he?
Because he's a heel.
Supposed to gain sympathy?
The heel is supposed to gain sympathy.
And also burn down, and also our babyface, our hero, is supposed to burn down the house?
Yes.
Perfect.
I dealt with arson all week considering the factory in Brooklyn that burned down. That's like 3 miles from my house.
Mick and Sammy have a backstage segment.
So,
Foley basically embraces Saints and good luck to you.
So, I have a question. to you, is Sami Zayn possibly the next Mick Foley?
I think Sami Zayn is gaining some support. Well, fortunately, he's like Mick Foley in this sense that they don't have the corporate backing.
Here's the thing, is he's the PG Mick Foley because he doesn't have that, you know, PG-14 hardcore edge.
Yeah, I don't think he needs it, though.
He doesn't. However, if he got one, I'm not arguing.
What the fuck are you doing? Tage, chill.
Stretch my legs.
Chill, Xavier.
He's trying to imitate our most wonderful imaginary wrestling character of all time, the wrestling thug. But I'm still convinced. I'm still convinced that gimmick would have worked.
No, it won't.
Sweet shit music. Boom. How did the gimmick not work? Just like slide in while they present a Susan D. Coleman check. Get the check and just like slip out of the ring and run away. Show up at like one of the superstars' relatives' funeral and do what the boss man did: steal the caskets of himself for money. No, that's his gimmick, because he always comes in with, like, baggy clothes.
Let's not do that.
So wait, he's, like, Hancock from...
Yeah.
He's Cock Hancock.
Yeah, he's a hobo, and he steals stuff and sells it for money.
Alright, so...
So essentially, he's Cock Hancock.
Yeah.
So Zayn and Foley backstage. So Zayn is, you know, essentially Foley hugging him, nice embrace. This is where Triple H comes in and says, have a nice day. Or something like that. I don't know what's wrong.
Yeah.
Two words for Triple H at that very moment. Those words were fuck you.
Those two words were...
That's not even a crotch chop. That's like a... That's like a... That's a Shawn
Michaels... That's like an Ori crotch chop.
It's a Shawn... Right, no, you know how Shawn Michaels could do the crotch chop?
Saturday number 5 crotch chop.
Shawn couldn't do the crotch chop at all. When he was burning a
Christmas. Who am I doing the crotch chop right now? Mike Tyson. Yeah, where he couldn't, like,
yeah.
He was just so jacked up. This is all he did.
Yeah.
He put his hands on an X and put it near his dick. That was like...
Okay. Then we have the Seth Rollins injury update with Kevin Wilt.
Kevin Wilt's booth.
You know who he looked like? You know who Kevin Wilt looked like? Here's the office space.
No.
Yeah.
He's Milt. He's
so, King. I don't really have anything to say here. Same old shit, different
though. It sucks. Speaking of sucks, Charlotte Flair versus Dana Brooke.
This match, it made no sense because Dana beat the shit out of her. And I was thinking, are they gonna like put Dana in the match because she's beating the shit out of Charlotte?
Why would you put
Charlotte
randomly put someone in the match?
Charlotte hits.
Oh wait, look at that.
Charlotte hits like one or two.
Why would you
moves.
Even that?
Charlotte hits like one or two moves in the match.
One.
Like,
it was a kick.
I was trying to demonstrate it.
Yeah. But, like, I'm just very confused here because, like, Dana looked like she was actually having a pretty decent, like, squash match against Charlotte. And then one kick later, right?
And
over,
then,
like, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think Dana should have won.
She should have. And guess what? She didn't because Charlotte has to win every match. So, she can't.
And the one that Charlotte loses still doesn't make sense.
Alright, ready? So, Dana broke. She is a shitty wrestler. Always will be a shitty wrestler. I don't think, in my opinion.
No.
Stephanie McMahon and her massive boobs backstage.
With the hedge clippers.
Should we say it? We just... Ready?
She was cutting everyone with nuts.
That
finish him.
You know what that is? You may be calling yourself a smart player, but she is the nuts player. I think Dave Meltzer put it best. So the main difference between Big Man, Vince, and Stephanie. Vince got his ass kicked. Eventually.
Yeah.
Stephanie will not get her ass kicked.
Eventually.
It's not. Here's the thing, if you think it's because she's a chicken, or they don't want to put that on TV. I remember not too long ago, Trish and Lita used to take bumps and moves all the time and get up for it.
Well, that was like 17 years ago?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
They are just, to quote one of my favorite kings of all time, King Julian of Madagascar, they are just a bunch of bonzies.
Well, then, because I bet that you're still a fucking child and you quote children's movies, I don't take that quote seriously.
Hey, disrespect Madagascar, I'm incredibly, incredibly.
Have you played the Madagascar demo game on the computer?
I played the full game and beat it 100%.
I don't think you played the demo now, did you?
I did not play the demo.
That's right, as I thought.
How do you like Leo with the real Kevin Owens?
This is the best segment on the fucking show. Except for the point where Kevin Owens came out and
was
just with Lucifer.
That was awesome. That was awesome.
Douchebag, faggot, asshole.
You know what he should have done? I hated it too, but...
Douchey McGee.
He should have burned it.
Yeah.
Douchey.
He should have burned it. Burned it, and then farted on it.
Hey.
You know what he should have done? Nothing.
Why?
He should have been put on the fucking list. Because he deserves it because he's an asshole.
Well, guess what? He'll never be on the list.
Kevin Owens, you guys listen to Ring Rust Radio. Asshole. He's an asshole. You guys listen to Ring Rust Radio podcast. Have you heard the Kevin Owens story where he lied about the match ending? Shoot. In Massachusetts. So apparently, he was waiting in line with five guys, and a guy was going to a show later on knows who was him in front of him, and he whispered, you know, it was like, "Kevin Steen," turns around, it's like, "Yeah, what's up?" And he was pretty nice to him. He's like, "Hey, guess what? I'm winning tonight." And he lost. Because he told him to bet some money on him. And he did. And he lost. You want to get some real heel heat, that's how you do it. He cost people $20.
Douche.
Hey, you know what? It's awesome. Even they probably were the closest Jericho.
That's one of the things that I always like about Jericho, too, is if he's a heel, he'll act like a jackass in public. If he's a face, he'll, like, talk to fans.
Yeah.
I think the best one is when he full on gets like hugged by a fan and he blasts them.
Security, do your fucking job. All right.
Douche.
Great segment. I love the segment. TJ Perkins versus Brian Kendrick for 30 seconds.
It happens.
I can say this for one thing. I'm gonna. Thank you. For squashing TJ Perkins.
And all Chris had to say was, what did you have to say about that little booklet? You know, the passport?
It's not physically possible.
Explain this to the viewing audience that
See,
doesn't exist for us, but still.
See, people. Viewing audience, apparently it doesn't exist in order to Steve the fuckboy Goku.
It's
the
Spark Slayer.
So, we... You cannot, as citizens of the United States, leave the country without your passport and get trapped in another country.
Yes.
You know why? Because they don't let you leave. They'll say, you know what? Go ahead, fly to another country without a passport. It's their problem, not ours. They don't do that.
It's kind of the American way, but at the same time, nothing.
You can't leave the country without a passport. If you try to, you're going to get arrested.
Yeah.
So, it's not physically possible for you to leave the country without the passport in your possession. I can guarantee you that was Brian Kendrick's passport.
Probably was. I was going to say, aren't passports blue? Not red?
Yeah.
Japan.
Yeah. I think
that
you
said Japan, that's what it is.
Maybe it's a passport.
Well, I don't catch a passport over there, too. Who knows?
Okay.
You're still there a lot.
You good? Next segment?
Yep.
Boring fuck face head in. Spared no expenses. Food sampling, he says he's gonna win. It sucked.
Obviously, because that's what they always say.
Goldberg, Brock Lesnar build-up. This book never on the show, I like to do that.
Well, I'm gonna get to something at the end about Brock, but anyways. Yeah, I mean, it was a fantastic promo. All the promo work done between Goldberg and Brock is A+. It just, this is gonna be a payoff.
So much it was backstage.
Is this where they...
One of my issues with Goldberg, he talks so much better than
I think this... No. The first one was when she ran into... Bayley was talking to her backstage.
Yep.
This is the one where Stephanie came up and announced that they were going to be in the handicap match.
Yep. Cesaro and Sheamus backstage, talking to Foley, saying goodbye to him. Next match. Bayley versus Nia Jax in an NXT match. A match that ended without any... WrestleCold.
So now, for your women's championship at WrestleMania, is a fatal four-way match now with Bayley, Sasha, Charlotte, and Nia Fats.
Fat chick. King Kong.
You know, the human trampoline.
Fat
Fat chick sits on it. That's her finisher.
The human trampoline herself.
Women's History Month quote promo. I went up and I went to my fear
Nia Jax. We will get sucked up.
Well, she's not like most girls. She's not like a bicycle princess.
Yeah, she's a vortex.
You are a factory of sadness.
If I was ever a WWE star and I was playing hide and seek, no, I do. I'd go over to Nia Jax. Hey, I'm just gonna hide right here. I just
inside
like,
of you.
I pop up inside and just hide under the rolls of fat.
So now we have Michael Cole interviewing.
Please be unconscious.
So, this is basically where Triple H challenged Seth Rollins to a match at WrestleMania. First, he was very reluctant about it, and he said, "Seth Rollins, if you have the balls, show up next week, sign the contract, and we'll have an unsanctioned match at WrestleMania."
I enjoyed the CM Punk chants. I find Triple H boring on the mic.
I don't know, I think he's been a lot better on the mic, though, as a heel.
He's better at antagonizing people, but man, is he still wrong. He's still dumb. But fine, we're going to get a match of Phoenix, too.
I want to go with this match. Okay.
Okay, 30 seconds. So, 30 seconds of your life, and then we get back.
Cesaro and Sheamus versus Luke Gallows, Carl Anderson, and fucking faggot and Big Cass.
Hey, come on.
Anyway. So this match lasted probably about
30 seconds.
Less than a minute. So that match lasted probably less than a minute, like you said, 30 seconds. First of all, it wasn't even a handicap match at all to begin with, because within seconds they were already fighting with each other. So
this was just a pointless feud.
And then Andy the Big Gal got fucking destroyed. So,
New Day backstage.
They talk about WrestleMania, not having it up.
Excuse me for that, but the segment opens with Big E and Kofi Kingston looking at Xavier like this.
Like, you done fucked up.
Yeah.
That was hysterical. I literally didn't catch that until I saw the meme of it, like the next day.
What did you do? I will say this, for the
I know what Xavier was doing. He was inside of Paige.
What? Wow. Or who?
Biggie? Question is when? Biggie? You weird fuck.
Who? Paige. When? Yeah. The bedroom. The when?
When
in a house?
The bedroom?
In a bedroom. Where? In the bedroom. Why? Because he wanted to fuck. So.
No, ready? What? Like,
how?
Why?
Because he wanted. So how? Because it happened.
Ready? Why? Don't you?
Yeah, exactly.
But anyway,
that 2014 page? Absolutely. Everyone wanted to fuck 2014 page.
Anyway, that's what I was saying. For Goldberg, I mean, Big E being weird fuck.
Oh. I don't know what.
Versus
Goldberg!
He's been on a weird drug the last year.
I don't know what drugs Big E is on, but I want
them. Until he forgets everything, he quotes Big E's faults. Right.
He humps
a fucking.
I go to FYE. I've been to FYE. Once a week, asking them when are booty pops coming in, and they still don't know.
Yeah, because they haven't been advertised yet.
I bought Bootios from them. I love Bootios. They're delicious.
Big, it's fucking Lucky Charms. Okay, let's be real
here.
It's delicious. I had it. I wanted
apparently,
the fucking box of it.
Apparently, Xavier Woods didn't get the message of his own servant. Bootios, make sure you went booty. Anyway.
Wait a minute, he went booty.
Well, I was going to say, you know what would have been a perfect line for that? We've been testing Bootios on unsuspecting people since 2014.
Warning, no animals were harmed in the making of this product.
Everyone's harmed in the making of this product.
Everyone's
harmed in the making of this product, except for Paige. She thoroughly enjoyed it.
No one's harmed in the making of this product, but one person was mad at it. Okay.
But I bet it's in a film.
Austin Aries versus Conan Gable.
I found it. It's hilarious. You shouldn't even love me. I'm like, okay. Alright.
It's like, okay, you really should become the wrestling thug, but you do what you do.
He looks like he's broken. Broken Brad. Did you know his name on the indie scene is Mad Brad?
Was it?
Yeah, it is. It's so stupid.
It sounds like the name of a ironically cereal box.
Sounds like the name of a fucking serial killer.
Murder the nose. Alright, Austin Aries.
He murdered Paige. He murdered Paige's pussy, is what he did.
Okay, here we go. Austin. No, enough. Okay, let's move on. So let's turn the page. Let's take the little bit.
That's what they should do.
Let's take the little bus trap.
This is what they should do at WrestleMania. They should have the microphone. They should have a guy walk up and just go, fuck her right in the pussy. Run off. Everyone will get it. Because it happens to people.
It happened to Xavier Woods.
Okay.
And he thoroughly enjoyed it. See,
happy birthday.
Xavier thoroughly enjoyed it. So, you can tell.
We're having too much fun with this, and we're going to continue to have too much fun with it until WWE does something good.
Everyone will. It's fucking hysterical.
Austin Aries versus Tony Nese.
I don't say it enough, but I do enjoy Omar at this point, so on the same page, this is one of those rare times.
Austin Aries versus Tony Nese.
Good match.
I've been trying to get this.
Another situation where we're all on the same page.
Yeah, I get the cruiserweights.
Austin Aries versus Tony Nese, because Austin Aries is the man.
He's the greatest man that ever lived. He's AW. He even came out this week and slapped hands with fans. When has he ever done that? He's face. Like,
Emma backstage.
Don't care.
Oh, I have a video package.
Don't care.
Okay, once again.
I'm telling you, she's going to debut, and then she's going to walk back and
yeah,
say,
so we got Brian of you and then boring. Okay, so don't care, so Braun versus Roman. Undertaker comes out old and slow and fat, and he gets speared, and he chokeslams Braun Strowman, and he winces in pain.
Alright.
End of that.
Here's the thing. He took a spear and he got up from it.
He also chokeslammed Braun Strowman and winced in pain.
Yes, he did, but then he took a spear and looked fine.
But I think it was either Brian Zane or it was Brian Zane. He's like he said that wasn't a wince of pain, it was a wince of like, ah shit, Roman is right behind me still.
Yeah.
But it's not, because he needs hip surgery.
He needs hip surgery, he's got a bad shoulder, he's overweight, and he's old.
He also has just remained here.
Let's assume you're right, even though I'm kind of with whatever that person's in.
Brian,
you know what? Using a chokeslam, I guess, kind of constitutes using your hip a little bit to get that person up.
Brian Zane.
But being speared and then getting up fine tells me that obviously Roman knows where not to hit him.
It still doesn't mean the match is going to be good.
What?
It still doesn't mean the match is going to be good.
See, the match is not
going to
be good. You know why? Just take a wild guess at why the match is not going to be good.
Because the crowd isn't going to be good.
Nope.
Because
that's okay, so number one, you're wrong. Number two, why? I'm going to give you as many reasons why until you get it right.
Why is the match not going
to
be good?
You need to have reasons why. You're on two now.
Well, you know, I can't think of reasons.
You guys are not going to shut up. He's old, he's 52 years old, he's fat, and he's slow, and he needs surgery. So that's the reason why.
No, I'm going to tell you reasons the match is going to be good.
Nope, because it's not going to be.
Shoot.
Right. Should The Undertaker still has the best character in the business.
Doesn't matter if he's the best character in the business. If he's 52 years old, and he's old, fat, and slow, and he's surgery, it doesn't matter if he's the best character.
Roman literally has to make zero effort to portray the villain in that match, so...
Want him to betray the villain a little bit better and not try at all and be the villain? There's no one going to...
That's not necessarily
a bad thing. He's not going to like Roman regardless.
I'm still going to boo him.
I'm still gonna like Roman regardless, just like I still love Ziggler regardless. For Ziggler, and I love Ziggler. Usos are heels, and I've loved Usos for fucking 5 years, 6 years. I'm not gonna change my loyalties. Chris Jericho's a heel. I love Chris Jericho. I've always loved Chris Jericho. Everyone's always loved Chris Jericho.
There's sometimes when people turn heel and they actually this
because they cheer.
They're different reasons.
As much as you know, I kid when I say fuck Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens is a shit, and I still love Kevin Owens. He's a heel.
Kevin Owens, I still think he's a douchebag, basically.
He is douche. There's no.
We all know that.
Real life, too. So, there's no denying that he's a douche, but he's a fantastic wrestler. For a guy of his size, and he can hit a fucking 5-star frog splash off the top rope.
So,
I gave you 300 pounds.
I don't think the match is by any means going to be
bad.
It is going to suck.
I don't think it's going to be great. I don't think it's going to be bad. I think it's going to be in that okay, good moment.
It's going to be boring, slow.
Taker has not had a good match in
since
5 years.
Yeah. Since 5 years. Punk was his last great match.
I mean, this all
because
is
he got Punk got the best out of him, and he got the best out of him.
Like, I understand that
he's old. That's why the
character was so I understand this is he's not going to wrestle the same way he wrestled 5 years ago. But so I was thinking to myself, all right, how does Taker get to a bad situation where maybe he is not in the best shape and he needs help? And people hate Roman just dominating people and squashing them. They hate him when Roman squashes people, but if he's the villain here, what if Roman gets squashed instead? What if Roman at the gates, you know, just runs to Taker? Choke slam, tombstone, that's it.
So we're going to have two matches that are going to last a great world.
No, I think the Bird and Brock Lesnar is actually going to be a match.
Oh,
fuck,
suck.
Well, I think the shit with each other.
I think also, too, it's going
to
be a match,
be worse than that.
But it's not going to be more than 5 minutes. It's going to be they're probably going to add a stipulation to it, like a false count anyway, because it's
or last minute stand.
Yeah.
Okay,
I feel like, I honestly think maybe with a chance to take
it. I do last minute Sydney because I had one injury to it because Goldberg stood tall twice now against him. Well, three times now, actually. Yeah, coming in there.
Shitty match.
Shitty match at Mania.
And then after the match.
Count.
20.
You know what? What's going to happen? This is going to go. Because that's not going to exist.
He's going to attack the other game after the match.
This is not going to, he's not, this is going to be, he didn't match the face regardless of how I'm thinking.
Yeah, because look what they're building up to for next year.
Hmm?
Look what they're building up to next year. Brock versus Roman. Yeah.
Regardless of what happens in that match, the next night of Brock is going to be faced anyways.
Yep.
Oh,
shit. And fans
he
will
could, he could literally murder the Undertaker in that match.
He'll pull a John Cena.
And the next night, he'll come out as the face.
He'll pull a John Cena, he'll come out and say, Dear Mercy, so now we go on. Or from mistakes.
Yeah. Don't worry. He can come out. He's gonna come out and say that guy. You know, I doubted the Undertaker or something like that. Like,
I don't think so.
I respect him. You know, it's his yard. He took it from me. Originally, it was his yard. I took it from him by choice, and then I took my yard back.
Actually, he didn't take the yard.
He took the yard.
No, he actually didn't take the yard. He just was dubbed the yard because of Michael Cole calling him the big dog or the guy. Or,
you know what? It's his
here
yard.
Here comes the man.
Yard is.
Undertaker's yard.
It's his yard.
It looks like
yard. Roman Reigns' yard.
Here's the thing. I hate part-timers going to work. I always hate it. Always will be.
I never really thoroughly enjoy it.
So you're cheering for Roman Reigns, what you're saying?
No, I'm just. The match is going to blow. The match is going to blow.
So you're cheering for Taker.
I'm not cheering for anyone.
I'm not cheering for anyone in the match. I really don't care. I wanted to see John Cena
and Taker.
I didn't want to see Roman versus fucking Taker.
Here's the thing. The match will suck either way. Either it was Cena or it was Roman. It will suck either way. Because Taker's still the same 58-year-old man with a bad shoulder and a bad head. Last time he went into WrestleMania and hurt like that, guess what happened? The match blew. Sucked. Horribly. WrestleMania
Brocky.
15. No, WrestleMania 15. Big boss man. Got a bad hip.
Yeah, he was breaking down then. But he had a bad shoulder then.
And
but Brock, too, that match was fucking atrocious.
And then they,
I still think it's the right decision. Mm-hmm. No matter what, it's the right decision.
Nope. If you had the streak, then the person fought can be an active streak. Right away.
Started losing WrestleMania the year before.
Oh god. Yeah.
He called himself the new face of fear. People are dubbing him the new Undertaker. Guess what?
He lost
all of his WrestleMania matches so far.
He's lost.
He's losing this one coming up too.
Yep.
Let's see. He's
what
lost.
In his stable, got embarrassed last year by The Rock,
who might not even be a Mania this
year.
Yeah,
he basically lost last year.
So, The Rock might not even be a Mania this year, by the way.
How was that?
The Rock basically came out headset and he tied them in their face.
Vince will get behind it, and that makes more sense because he's a heel. So you keep him a heel and you make it
Confusion.
But a jeer is a jeer.
Come on, do these already, guys.
And what happened?
It hit.
They should have turned figs that first one.
That's the one I came
on.
It's in there.
Yeah, you should have turned figs.
Sounds like Eric Carter.
Man.
I wonder if you're going to test up on Ida.
Did you go there specifically for that? Okay, so now we go to the shit segment. I want to talk about Brock Lesnar for a second here.
Brock Lesnar?
Brock.
Coxner.
Brock.
So, WWE now has Brock Lesnar appear backstage at events. He's been doing it three times a month. Every single time, the dark match is him versus Big Show with Brock winning. Every single time. Guess what? It wastes Brock Lesnar's days.
I'm not sure if Brock... I don't know what Brock Lesnar is in real life. I'm not sure if he's the kind of person that will do handshake and deals.
He's a dick.
He doesn't see natural.
He doesn't see
himself.
All right. You ever want to bring it to the table, even though I told you to do five times, but Paul Heyman showed a diagram of where Brock Lesnar lived on a piece of paper. So, basically, right? And he says, go ahead.
No, I can't use it.
You go to the back. Hey, you're also lying. All right? People. Brock Lesnar. So people all the way on the other side. Brock Lesnar.
And he moved from Minnesota.
He doesn't even have a driveway. He basically just has a road. And it ends at Brock Lesnar's house. If you think Cards and Cowardly Dog lived in the middle of nowhere, you haven't seen shit.
He lives in the middle of nowhere in Saskatchewan and his kids play hockey. So.
And he has three former friends. And apparently Coach Sagan eats one off each one every day. You know why? It was Brock Lesnar. That's why. Yeah.
But like, I found my Brock Lesnar shirt for the wearing the first game.
Also, it's still very interesting.
By the way, Steven, you're going to miss my t-shirt of choice. I think John does it over here. Where is it in here? You're going to be missing my t-shirt of choice. It's a dig at Xavier Woods.
Oh,
I'm
going to wear
the booty or shirt.
But by the way, I want my t-shirt of course. And I'll pick the wrestler.
I never agreed to that.
You also said you never agreed to the fact that you get the
those
by
meetings.
Him.
I'm not getting WrestleMania tickets and taking it back. I promise you I took your house and I didn't. I'm flaking.
Yeah, because you're a fucking flake.
I am a flake.
We're a fucking flake. I invite you to my house as a guest. As a friend of mine.
I invite you to my house as a guest as a friend of mine.
I invited you first to my house. Three times.
Don't say the fact I still did it.
I invited you both to the show.
I am a flake. But more particularly, I'm a frosted flake because I'm great.
I will,
and I taste great. Ask anyone.
That's gross.
So what were you again?
Some people eat at your asshole?
Not necessarily. One's
age?
John. Three. Steve. Half.
None. None. Steve is zero. Okay.
Alright.
Yes,
so please. I'll pick the page.
Pick that page. Give me a page t-shirt. That'd be awesome.
Hey honey, I got a t-shirt for you.
Hey honey, what's Brad Bash been doing since he left WWE? I don't know, I hear he has a job making minimum paid wage.
So I will tell you what
so
shirt
he had turned the page on his job application and he got hard.
In fact, I'm gonna take a look here.
I
mean,
I think I went through a lot of it, like in brief.
Yeah,
on SmackDown.
On SmackDown, we'll get to that. We'll get to SmackDown. We don't want to talk about SmackDown. Because we know the bed where my tape is. So look behind you.
I know he has the championship. He can't get his hands off the championship. He has like a fucking like massive erection every time he touches it.
Nope. Alright, so.
There's a massive erection every single time he touches his championship.
I gotta go to class.
Yeah, fuck you.
I'll send you a text on what shirt I want, and that's the shirt to wear.
No promises. I'm not shaking anything on that one.
Well, we have to buy him tickets to Mania still, so...
I'm not buying him tickets.
Hope you're playing. Well, you have to.
You know what I'll buy you?
The deal. You have to obey the deal.
I'm breaking the contract.
You can't break the contract. We shook on it.
I didn't sign anything.
We shook.
Because a handshake and deal.
I heard, so you'll get me a shirt next year. And I said, okay.
And then, no, you did not.
Yeah, I did.
You said you give me, okay, you said, okay.
Here was the bet. If Sting retired, I get a t-shirt.
Yeah, you get a t-shirt.
If
you didn't specify when. If I don't get you a t-shirt, all right, how about this?
If you don't give me a t-shirt by Mania, you owe me Mania tickets. It's been a year.
Deal.
That's the deal.
All right. So you bang him another WrestleMania ticket then.
What was it? I pick the shirt. You lost. I picked the shirt.
Deal.
All right. Good. Great.
Well, then you want to lose.
Give 2 weeks.
One more thing. Actually, I have one. Oh, I just made that list for myself. All right. I just said one other thing that I want y'all to remember.
Yeah, want y'all to remember?
Want y'all to remember.
Want y'all?
That this pick is going to lose his title at the NXT TakeOver.
The fucking title.
Bitch. Orlando. In the Orlando Arena with all the college students and their drunkards and their stuff. Yeah, he's going to lose.
Extremely
racist.
You know what? You know what, Steve? You actually have to beat me for this championship.
John,
to talk.
I'm
going to
beat you.
You have to actually beat me for this championship before you can talk.
You're 0-2, by the way, against him.
Third time's the charm.
See? Me,
not
two-time
only
champion,
am I like Frosted Flakes, I'm
me,
like Lucky Charms.
Two-time champion.
I'm Irish
me,
and the luck is on my side.
Me, two-time champion.
Right.
You, zero-time champion.
Let's get to the
You've
end.
Only felt this championship.
Run up the store.
Yeah, you want to shut the lights off, you bitch.
What's the point?
You bitch, you want to shut those lights off, didn't you?
You're not.
Oh, look at that. Oh, you know, you don't want to shut those lights off, you little pansy. Yeah, because the light switch is over there.
Yep.
Not over there. That just partially shuts it off.
Yep. All right.
Pansy.
Let's get to SmackDown. Daniel Bryan backstage.
Daniel Bryan was backstage. AJ came in. He said he reluctantly re-signed him back to the Smack It Down brand.
Yep.
And that was it, pretty much.
AJ Styles promo.
AJ cut a promo saying that he's gonna wait for Shane McMahon backstage in the parking.
Daniel Bryan backstage.
He was on the phone with Shane, and Shane was saying on the other end that he's gonna be there too.
American Alpha versus the Usos for the SmackDown Tag Titles, which is where I will take over. As I said, I will defer my take until we get to the point of the show where I get pissed off. This is where I get pissed off. Right, so when the Usos won the title, I was saying, oh, that's kind of fucking stupid. You have the American Alpha win the championships, take them off TV for 3 weeks, have them come back, have a tag team tournament where they win, and have them lose the third.
Yep. So, or they could have lost that championships earlier if Connor had just pinned Jason Jordan,
yep,
who was laid out, and instead they went for the Fall of Man, which I knew they were going to lose after that.
We also have the issue of there have been 12 WWE main title changes.
Yeah.
Every championship has changed hands. So I'll give you the crisp me out from here. So basically, here's the thing.
We're going to the front.
Yep. All right, so here's what they've done. Throw me the belt.
Hot potato.
Read this 12 times.
Yeah, here we go. That's 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't think you got the picture yet. 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Thank you. 12
13.
Frickin' times. That title change, that a championship in World Wrestling Entertainment has changed hands, as demonstrated by your lovely hosts.
So, as you can see, that was a bit annoying what we did there for the fans. So that's annoying for us.
It is.
So we count the waves.
Oh, freaking time.
Dean Ambrose wins the IC belt.
That kicked it off.
Yeah, that kicked it off. That's what it started. Then Jericho won the US belt. Alpha won the tag titles. Then, at the Rumble, the Cruiserweight title changed hands.
At the Universal title.
Universal, not the Universal title. WWE title changed
hands. Oh, yeah, that's the fast time.
WWE Championship, then won by John. Fuck. SmackDown, I'm sorry, Raw Tag Team titles.
Yeah.
Dallas Anderson won from Sheamus and Cesaro. Alexa Bliss lost her SmackDown Women's Championship.
They gained it back.
And then gained it back, so that's two. Then we get Bray Wyatt winning the title.
Yep.
Then we have Bayley winning that, the championship.
The Usos.
The Usos. And Goldberg winning the Universal title.
12 people!
And you know what's happening at WrestleMania? More titles!
More! Every title looks like it's about to change hands.
So we're going to be up to 20. It's fucking ridiculous. It's an average of 4 per month. We're not even at the end of March yet.
Not even halfway through the year yet,
yeah.
Let alone.
We're only a quarter of the way.
We're at number 2 of the big 3.
Yep.
We're not even at SummerSlam yet.
Yep. Yeah, we've had 12 title changes. 12 total. We're not even counting NXT, which has 2, so that's 14.
Yeah.
Because the Office of Pain and that group.
There's no holdover champion in NXT.
Other than Asuka.
Other than Asuka, that was from 2016.
Yep. It's effing ridiculous.
It is stupid.
Why the hell are we having this championship match change? We're going to have all this stuff. We're going to have really long-term booking champions. I think the main reason why people don't care about something is because we don't have long-term champions. None of them
are long-term. They're all very short-term champions.
Yep.
All won from January on.
I see. Because Ambrose is facing Gordon officially now, so
yeah.
I think Gordon's going to be the IC belt. I think the Raw Tag Team title is going to change hands. I think Enzo Cassidy won that.
Please save us all.
Brock's obviously going to win the title.
Yeah.
Or to win the title. New SmackDown Women's Champion.
Yeah, oh, yeah, I'm almost guaranteeing that.
Yep. I probably going to get Hobie, actually. Just go back.
Depends if she's healthy enough.
So that's 5.
US
belt.
US belt, yeah. US belt probably is going to change hands for the next month.
And maybe the SmackDown Tag Team titles and the Raw Women's Championship. Those are two more chances as well. So, who knows? They might be up to 20 by the time the WrestleMania is over. It's really goddamn ridiculous. I lost my mind. I sat for an hour and I sulked for an hour. I didn't watch SmackDown for about the rest of the show.
And I'll take from here because I watched
SmackDown.
I rather prefer the American Alpha be long-term champions myself too. You know, they're specimens.
Yep,
he's the best tag team they've had in years.
Yep.
And the Usos aren't my favorite tag team, but you know, it's nice. I love the fact that they won, but you know, it wasn't really necessary to do it here. Or even at Mania.
Yeah.
But I would have saved it for a bigger show, maybe SummerSlam or, you know, Survivor Series. Like, later on in the year, have the Usos finally get their title for the first time since 2014. But, you know, to do it on a random SmackDown 2 weeks before the biggest pay-per-view of the year,
yep,
doesn't make any sense. So then we have Luke Harper backstage, and he was very cryptic in this backstage segment. Wyatt's wrote basically Wyatt family style promo, and he's such rambling on about something that I don't know what the hell he's talking about. He's like, I'm gonna face, I forget who he said he was gonna face, but they were like an hour later, they're like, he's gonna face Bray Wyatt next week, and I'm like, he was alluding to the fact that he's gonna face Randy Orton next week, but I guess he's gonna face Bray Wyatt.
Which I would say,
the most confusing out of fucking promo. You know, this is, again, Lost Total Bella episodes. This was not funny at all. Very, very cringeworthy and not funny. It was almost funny, I forgot to laugh. And then we have Baron Corbin versus Randy Orton. And this match is okay.
Mm-hmm.
At the end, Ambrose comes up in a forklift. Distracts Baron Corbin. Orton gets the pin with the RKO.
So Orton gives him enough distraction. That asshole.
So we have Ambrose On the forklift, everyone comes down for the forklift.
What's up with
the ambulance
room when it won't ring the vehicles?
I don't know.
Ambulances.
I mean, it kind of ties in because Corbin beat the shit out of him with forklift.
Yep.
But,
disrespectful acts. Oh, by the way, Marlon Ronell not on the show.
We'll talk about that afterwards. So he, you know, Randy gets the win. Ambrose comes up, weighs him out with dirty deeds, says he accepts his challenge for WrestleMania. So, Randy goes backstage with Renee Young, lights flicker on and off, they go out. And then, you know, they have the typical Wyatt family gaze, you know, black and whatnot. And there's a bunch of, like, clones of Eric Rowan with a sheet mask, and his old attire is green. This, everyone's like wearing green, you know, suit, green like Eric Rowan type ring attire with the sheet mask. The old one they used to wear, the white one, for the first ones that he has now, the first one he has now with hair, which is creepy. But, so they hold back Orton, and Bray Wyatt comes out with a cross, and I forget what he says, but he like kind of taps Orton with it, like he fucking just knighting him. It's really weird. And he starts talking in, you know, fucking weird tone.
Riddles.
Then we had Fandango with Tyler Bella versus John Cena. This match sucked. It was a squash match. Tyler Breeze came out, as I said, like dressed like Nikki Bella for some fucking strange reason. I don't know why. It's fucking very disturbing. Cena, you know, Fandango gave his commentary partner at South Park Wrestling a fashion ticket. And Cena just destroyed him. And then Cena and Nikki Bella hit their finishers and the SDFs. Becky versus Carmella, I don't know how far, like, I wasn't really paying attention at the point in time. I stopped paying attention after the Baron Corbin match. There's just background noise at that point. Because it was on YouTube. And, I know at one point Natalya was on top commentary, came into the ring, and beat up Carmella. I don't remember Neville being backstage, I don't remember that very much. I think it's just him announcing
his
match.
I will beat Austin Aries, that pussy.
I think it's him announcing his match. I think he's a 205 live.
King of the Cruiserweights.
So, then it shows AJ backstage in the parking lot. He's looking for Shane. Still. But, a car comes driving in, and it's Slater Ren. Uses the perfect disguise. He goes to punch Shane, but Slater Ren, he stops, and, you know, it's obviously a distraction because Shane was deadly in the car. He gets it. So then Shane's music hits literally 3 seconds after that. Like, he somehow became fucking The Flash. And then ran from that car down to the ring in like a quarter of a second. And they show Renee Young went up to AJ and said, Shane's in the ring. And he looks dumbfounded. And so he comes out. And by the way, this is how Biz Titan's entrance was. They showed him walking backstage on the Titantron. They showed him walking to the ring. He got onto the stage. Onto the stage, and then his music came. He was already halfway to the ring, and his music came. I was like, wow, there's no point. He was already through the curtain, he was like, all on his way down to the ring, and then the music played. I was like, what do you do that before?
Is this AJ or Sean?
AJ. This is like, AJ was walking.
Okay, so he's like halfway down the ring, and also did.
Yep. He went through, it wasn't halfway, but like he came up to, he was like standing like right on the before the entrance ramp. He had come up through the entrance. He had come up through the curtain. And then his music came. And it's like, you're off at this point. So he comes down to the ring, he's being very reluctant to get into the ring because Shane's gonna kick his ass, obviously. He tries to apologize and Shane throws some shitty punches, like he always does. It's literally what it was. And no awful. At one point, AJ fell out of the ring and Shane's still punching the air for some reason. And then he goes on the outside, he eats a suplex on the barricade. AJ goes over, takes off the cover to the announce table, and he then then suplexes him onto the cover of the announce table. Obviously, sets him up for what eventually was the leap of faith elbow.
Yep.
That went through the table, which I like to call the diving punch, because he breaks the table himself and just punches AJ. That's all he does. He doesn't hit with an elbow, a forearm, nothing. His fist hits AJ.
Yep.
The rest of his body breaks the table, and of course, AJ being a fucking boss-ass motherfucker,
sells it like a champ. He should be the champ.
Before we sign off, there's not going to be much to talk about after this.
Well, yeah, I was thinking about doing a part two and waiting for Steve to get back. Because we had to do a top five for WrestleMania, which we haven't done.
He's not going to be here for a while.
And that's fine.
You just want to do it on Friday? Monday.
Monday?
Monday, because we'll all be here.
Yeah.
Including Owen. So
yeah,
kind of,
so that's part.
We're going to leave Owen.
So I was going to log back on like two.
Yeah, so... What I wanted to bring up is more Ronella. He's been going through some very difficult times recently. Since he was a teenager, he was diagnosed with depression. And more recently, he had to leave a UFC event. He missed the UFC event because of his depression. And it came back again. And... his doctors are advising him to stay off social media, something that's pretty bad. If you're being told to stay off social media and you're depressed,
yep.
I'm thinking that that's not very good. He must have very severe depression then.
Yep.
So that explains his absence the past couple of weeks. You know, I hope he gets better. I'd hate to see him like this because he's the best commentator WWE has and has had since Jim Ross. And speaking of Jim Ross, we want to say our condolences to Jim Ross and his family. We are very sorry for your loss of your wife.
Yep.
It sucks. We heard she was the nicest lady on planet Earth. Everyone who's talked about her, from Triple H to Mick Foley, say she was the nicest person on planet Earth that they've ever met. So we want to say sorry for your loss, Jim Ross. We hope you can get through this. And it sucks.
Alright, so plugging time?
It's plugging time!
So make sure you watch the CM Brothers and Owen with the Talkinator channels on YouTube.
And I guess if we forgot any more, Owen will put them in the description, or 30 preset in the description anyway.
Watch the Football Reporters 230 for other football update videos.
Make sure you yell at him and put him in the top of the description, because we did that the other day for our show.
Yep, watch John Tutty, JOHNT5. South Park reviews, vlogs are coming out on Monday.
Yeah! You ready for that, people? I'm going to be tuning in.
That's
I probably will be one of the very...
Only one. It's like one view. It's one consistent view. So that's coming on Monday, starting with Carbon Gets an Anal Probe. That's the first episode.
Yeah, that's pretty exciting.
Yep. Steve, I don't think, has any channels, so
no,
5.
Steve doesn't have any channels, so fuck him.
So John 5, Steve 0. He's going to walk in this room when we're with him. All right, so that's going to do it for us. Does Owen, what does Owen say at the end of the
day? Nothing. He just fucks around.
Bye.
We'll see you, guys.
Monday.
See you.